Hello students, in continuity of chapter 7, we are going to study about animal frog in detail. In this lecture, we are going to study about morphology, it means external characteristics, as well as anatomy of body of frog. Frog is a cold-blooded organism and having ability to change color to hide from enemy, as you know very well. It can live both on land and fresh water and belong to class Amphibia of phylum Chordata. The most common species of frog found in India, that is Rana tigrina. They do not have constant body temperature, like their body temperature varies with the temperature of the environment. And such animals, they are called as cold-blooded or poikilotherm animal. Here, its body change in color of the frog while they are in grasses and on dry land. So, they have ability to change color. This protective coloration is called mimicry. So, this word is important here. They show the body color change to protect themselves, and this coloration is known as mimicry. They do not seen during the season, peak season of summer and winter. During this period, they take shelter in deep burrows to protect them from extreme heat and cold, because they do not have constant body temperature, that's why. This is called summer sleep, it means estivation, and winter sleep, hibernation respectively. If you talk about morphology, external features, their body is divisible into head and trunk region. They show bulbous structure covered by nictitating membrane. Differentiation of male and female frog is also there by their morphology or external feature. Male frog is different from female, having vocal sacs and copulatory pad on first digit of forelimb. This figure gives us clear idea about external features of frog. Here we can see organization of eye, mouth, limb structure, it means forelimbs and hind limbs, tympanic membrane, as well as web foot. The body skin of frog is smooth and slippery due to the presence of mucus. The skin is always maintained in a moist condition. The color of dorsal side of body is generally olive green with dark irregular spots. On the ventral side, the skin is uniformly pale yellow. The frog never drinks water but absorbs it through the skin. That is special feature of this animal. Body of frog is divisible into head and trunk region, as you can see in this figure also. Neck and tail are absent. Above the mouth, a pair of nostrils is present. Eyes are bulged and covered by nictitating membrane that protects them while in water. On either side of eye, a membranous tympanum is related with structure of ear, which receives sound signals. In this figure also, it is clearly observed arrangement of tympanic membrane. Forelimbs and hind limbs, they help in swimming, walking, leaping and burrowing condition. The hind limbs end in 5 digits and they are larger and muscular than forelimbs that end in 4 digits. Feet have webbed digits that help in swimming. This figure is also giving clear idea about arrangement of this web foot. So, this way frogs exhibit sexual dimorphism. Male frogs can be distinguished by the presence of sound producing vocal sacs and also a copulary pad on the first digit of the forelimb, which are absent in female frog. So this way, by studying this figure, now we have clear idea about external features or morphology of frog. Now, internal organs of frog is actually diagrammatic representation of internal organ of frog, which also show complete digestive system, vascular system, as well as parts of excretory system here. So it gives us clear idea about anatomy of frog or internal body organization of frog. As a part of digestive system, we can study here alimentary canal. It is opening of mouth. You can see here esophagus, gallbladder, liver, stomach, intestine, rectum and cloaca as a part of digestive system. Closed vascular system is observed here, and main parts, their heart, vessels and blood, they are arranged in this figure, that is internal organ of body of frog. Male and female reproductive system is also well developed in the body of frog. They also exhibit well developed excretory system in their body. So by studying this figure, you can get clear idea about internal organs of frog body, which show alimentary canal, parts of vasculatory system and reproductive system also. Now let's study one by one system organization as a part of anatomy or internal structure in the body of frog. The body cavity of frog is accommodate different organ system such as digestive, circulatory, respiratory, nervous system, excretory system and reproductive system with well developed structures and functions. First, let's study digestive system. It is mainly consist of alimentary canal and digestive glands. Alimentary canal is short because frogs are carnivores and hence length of intestine is reduced. The mouth opens into the buccal cavity that leads to the esophagus through pharynx. Esophagus is a short tube that open into the stomach, which is in turn continues as the intestine, rectum and finally at the end it opens outside by cloaca region. Liver secretes bile that is stored in gallbladder. Pancreas, a digestive gland, it produces pancreatic juice containing digestive enzymes. It is very helpful for digestion process. Food is captured by the bile of tongue. Digestion of food take place by the action of HCl and gastric juices secreted from the wall of the stomach. Partially digested food called chyme is passed from stomach to the first part of the small intestine, duodenum. The duodenum receives bile from gallbladder and pancreatic juices from the pancreas through a common bile duct. Bile emulsifies fat and pancreatic juices digest carbohydrates and proteins. So this way, digestion of carbohydrate, proteins and fat or lipid take place here. Final digestion take place in the intestine. After digestion process, digested food is absorbed by the numerous finger-like holes in the inner wall of the intestine, which is known as villi or microvilli. The undigested solid waste move into the rectum and passes out through cloaca. So this way, the well-organized digestive system is observed in the body of this animal frog. Frog respire on land and in the water by two different methods. In water, skin acts as aquatic respiratory organ and so one type of cutaneous respiration. Dissolved oxygen in the water is exchanged through the skin by process of diffusion. When it survives on the land, at that time the buccal cavity, skin and lungs act as the respiratory organs. Respiration by lung is called pulmonary respiration. Lungs are a pair of elongated pink color sac-like structure present in the upper part of the trunk region, that is thorax region. Air enters through the nostril into the buccal cavity and then to lungs. During aestivation and hibernation, gaseous exchange take place through skin. So this way, by two different respiratory organs, the process of respiration take place in the body of frog when it is in aquatic habitat or on land or terrestrial habitat. The vascular system of frog is well developed and it is of closed type, as well as they are having lymphatic system also. The blood vascular system involves heart, blood vessel and blood. Lymphatic system consists of lymph channels and lymph node. If we talk about heart of frog, it is a muscular structure situated in the upper part of the body cavity. It has three chambers, two atria and one ventricle and is covered by membrane called pericardium. Triangular structure called sinus venosus joins the right atrium. It receives blood through the major vein called vena cava. The ventricle opens into sac heart. Sconus enters on the ventral side of the heart. The blood from the heart is carried to all part of the body by the arteries, arterial system. Veins collect blood from different part of body to the heart and form the venous system. Special venous system connection between the liver and intestine as well as the kidney and lower part of the body are present in frog. Former is called hepatic portal system and the another is known as renal portal system. So two types are there, hepatic portal system and renal portal system. Composition of blood, it is composed of plasma and cells. Blood cells, they are mainly RBC or erythrocytes. It is red blood cell. WBC, it means white blood cell, are also known as leukocytes, and platelets are present. RBC are nucleated and contain red color pigment, namely hemoglobin. Lymph is different from blood. It lack of few proteins and RBC. Blood carries nutrients, gases and water to the respective sites during the circulation. Here, the circulation of blood is achieved by the pumping action of the muscular heart. So we can say, in the body of frog, vascular system is well developed and closed tight. It consists blood vascular system as well as lymphatic system. Excretory system of frog is also well developed. Here, elimination of nitrogenous waste, it is carried out by well developed excretory system. It is consist of a pair of kidney, ureter, cloaca and urinary bladder. These are compact, dark red and bean-like structure situated little posterior in the body cavity on both sides of vertebral column. Each kidney is composed of several structural and functional units. They are called uriniferous tubule or nephron also. Two ureters emerge from the kidneys in the male frog. The ureters act as a urinogenital duct which opens into the cloaca. In females, the ureter and the oviduct open separately in the cloaca. The thin walled urinary bladder is present ventral to the rectum, which is also open in the cloaca. So this way the frog excretes urea, and that's why it is known as ureotelic animal. Excretory waste are carried by blood into the kidney where it is separated and excreted. So elimination of nitrogenous waste is carried out by this type of well-developed excretory system in the body of frog. The system which control and coordinate is highly evolved in the frog, that is known as neural system, as well as it also possess endocrine glands. The chemical coordination of various organs of the body is achieved by hormones which are secreted by the endocrine glands. Prominent endocrine glands found in the body of this animal, these are pituitary, thyroid, parathyroid, thymus, pineal body, pancreatic ducts, and adrenal and gonads. The nerve system in body of this animal frog is organized into the central nerve system. It means CNS, made up of brain and spinal cord. A peripheral nerve system, that is cranial and spinal nerves, and an autonomous nerve system, that is sympathetic and parasympathetic system. There are 10 pair of cranial nerves arising from the brain. Brain is enclosed in the bony structure which is known as brain box, or we can also say that is cranium. Brain is divided into forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. Forebrain, which includes olfactory lobes, paired cerebral hemispheres and unpaired diencephalon. Midbrain is characterized by pair of optic lobes. And the last one, that is hindbrain, is a consist of cerebellum and medulla oblongata. So this way the body of frog as a part of nerve system, brain is well developed and divided into forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain structure. Medulla oblongata here passes out through the foramen magnum and continues into spinal cord, which is enclosed in the vertebral column. So this way well organized nerve system as well as endocrine glands are present here. When we talk about this neural system control and coordination, then we can also say in the body of frog they possess different sense organs, and they are for touch, sensory papillae, for taste, taste buds, for smell, nasal epithelium, for vision they have eyes, for hearing, tympanic membrane with internal ear. Eyes and internal ears are well organized structure, and the rest are their cellular aggregation around nerve endings. Eyes of frog, they are having a pair of spherical structure situated in the orbit in skull, and these are simple eyes. It means possessing only one unit. External ear is absent and only tympanum can be seen externally. Ear is an organ of hearing as well as balancing equilibrium. So the ear, that organ, is not only for hearing purpose, but it also balances its body or equilibrium. They possess well-developed reproductive system also. In male, male reproductive system having their typical organs. Female is also having well-organized female reproductive system or organs. Male reproductive organ, they consist of pair of yellowish ovoid testes which are found adhered to the upper part of kidney by mesorchyme. Female reproductive organs, they include mainly a pair of ovary which are situated near kidney. Fertilization in this animal, that is external, it means that it takes place outside of the body and as well as in the medium of water. After fertilization, development process takes place and it shows larval stage and it is known as tadpole, which survive in water. This tadpole undergoes metamorphosis to form adult animal. So when the frog laid new birth to young one, the newly born frog, at that time does not exactly look like its adult one or adult frog, but it passes certain stages in life and then it is converted into adult animal, and these changes, they are known as metamorphosis. Now let's study male reproductive system in the body of frog. This figure gives us clear idea about male reproductive system of frog. Here you can see some structures, organs. It's like one pair of kidney, one pair of testes, adrenal gland is located here, then urinogenital duct, then urinary bladder and glocal aperture. Vasa aprensia is clearly observed in this structure. Mainly, male reproductive organs, they consist of a pair of yellowish ovoid testes. Here you can see this testis structure in figure also in one pair, both side one one, which are found adhered to the upper part of kidney by a double fold of peritoneum called mesorchyme. Vasa aprensia, they are 10 to 12 in number that arise from the testis. They enter the kidney on their side and open into Bidas canal. Finally, it communicate with the urinogenital duct that come out of the kidney and opens into the cloaca region. So this way, one pair of testes is there, vasa aprensia arises, Bidas canal are there, it communicate with the urinogenital duct and come out of the kidney and opened into cloaca. In this figure also you can see the cloaca and cloacal aperture. What is cloaca? Cloaca is a small median chamber that is used to pass, that is, fecal matter, urine and sperms to the exterior. So we can say this cloaca is a multifunctional organ in the body of frog, because digestive system opens by this aperture structure. Then excretory system also open, as well as the reproductive system open by this porous structure. So cloaca and cloacal aperture, that is very important organ in the body of frog. Female reproductive system and its organization in the body of frog. Here we can see the female reproductive organs, which include a pair of ovaries. As you can see here, both side one ovary is there. That means the arrangement of one pair of ovary which are situated near kidneys, and there is no functional connection with kidneys. Other organs, that is a pair of oviduct, it is arising from the ovaries and opens into the cloaca, that is separately. So here we can see the arrangement of ovary, that is in one pair, oviduct is there, okay. And finally this ovaries, this opens into the cloaca separately. Mature female can lay 2500 to 3000 ova at a time. It's a very large number, you can see. Fertilization is external, it means it takes place outside of the body, and here medium is water. Development that involve a larval stage, which is tadpole, undergoes metamorphosis and then it is converted into adult one. So after birth it passes through some stages of life and then it is converted into adult structure, and this process mechanism they are known as metamorphosis. Frogs, they are beneficial to mankind also because they eat the insect and protect the crop. Frogs maintain ecological balance because they serve as important link of food chain and food web in ecosystem. In some countries, the muscular legs of frog are used as food by man. So this way we can say frog, these animals are beneficial for mankind.